Specialist technology recruitment firm InterQuest says the UK digital sector is facing a major shortage in the right kind of workers. Bolstered by a record 2015, the group says it will look to further its reach in the new digital economy and plug that gap in a rapidly growing market. Well, InterQuest Group CEO Chris Eldridge joins me now. Chris, thanks for coming in. First of all, tell me a little bit more about what you do and the space that you're in.
Well, InterQuest is a specialist recruitment organisation looking at a number of different in-demand technology areas. And we've evolved from being a reasonably generalist IT recruiter, probably the last 5 years and before that, and we've now really started to focus on the skills that are going to shape the digital transformation that most businesses are going to battle with probably over the next 5 years. Digital itself, analytics, large-scale change, and information security. And I think those are really kind of the focus problem areas for our client base over the few years to come.
And are you looking at temporary, permanent, contract, interim? What kind of recruitment firm are you?
So we're a mix, actually. You can put our services into three primary areas. Contract recruitment, so kind of 3 months, 6 months and beyond IT contractors. Highly specialist, very rare skill sets. Also permanent, where we're trying to find these kind of almost sought after skills on a permanent basis. And then we have a solutions part to our business, where we work with our clients and look after all of their recruitment needs, be it from a temp basis through to executive search.
So it's not just a one-hit wonder, it's not just about getting that job, getting that post, yeah. It's about building relationships too.
I think it's an understated kind of thing with recruitment, that all of our clients want to work with someone they can trust, a company that they can understand well, they can actually look under the bonnet. I think recruitment companies sometimes get a pretty bad rap, if I'm totally honest. And I think where we come from is we want to be an absolute expert in the space that we work in, to really understand those technologies, understand the buzzwords. We'll never perhaps be an expert in the technology itself, but if we can be an expert in the recruitment of that technology, I think that's when you start to have a meaningful relationship with your clients.
But just before, you said that some of it is very specialised and rare, hard to find.
Yes.
So what are you doing about changing that so that the pool of people on your books have the right skills?
I think we look at it from two perspectives. One is at the university end, and the other is trying to identify those very hard to find specialist skills. If I deal with the latter, we've been working in that space, that kind of really hard to find technology space, for probably the last 4 or 5 years. And what's driven our ability to identify candidates is building out candidate talent pools and thinking quite carefully about how we work with those contractors. It's very hard necessarily to get hold of these people and then pick up the phone. So we've then got a very strong social media platform as well. So we'll probably push out one or two pieces of content every day. We'll look to harvest those technology skills, be they domestically and internationally, and build a relationship through social media, through Twitter, through the format that and through the format and the channels that they want to then be spoken to. I think what's really important is this kind of soft headhunting. If we can identify those candidates, none of them will be actively looking for a role, but you kind of tap them on the shoulder, you have a conversation, you explain to them, I know you're not looking for a job, but if you were, what would it be, how much would you have to be paid, and so on and so forth. When the time actually comes and you've got something suitable for them, you get a far stronger response. I think at the other end, we're now working with a number of financial institutions where, yes, they want those very hard to find skill sets, but they do come at a premium. Now, what can we do about universities? So we're now working with two or three different universities, identifying graduates with STEM backgrounds, and then working through and just helping kind of transform those first kind of early few months and years into the corporate life. And that tends to be working very well for our clients.
So you've talked about what you're doing to solve the problem, but let's just put it into context and explain the scope of this problem.
I think there are a number of kind of facts that have been put out there. Some of it looks like it's going to be scaremongering. Others are very, very accurate. The Recruitment and Employment Confederation has pulled a statistic out that says that the UK industry are going to be 100,000 graduates short with STEM experience over the next 3 years. That's a colossal number. I think we've got to work really carefully about with those graduates, also with technology professionals who have a skill set that may be waning, that may be becoming commoditized, and how they're going to retrain into some of these high demand skill areas. And I think there's an immediate opportunity for that as well. But it's not just in It's not just with STEM graduates, also cybersecurity. There's a significant shortage of people with the necessary skills, both in the UK and internationally. I think we're going to have to work really carefully over the next months and years to ensure that we see the necessary demand coming through to support the industry.
You talked through the scope of the market, but where's the growth going to come from for you? How are you going to make it happen? Are we talking organic growth through acquisitions?
I think historically, if you look back at InterQuest and where we've come from, we've been very much a buy and build organisation. We've bought businesses in particular areas where we're seeing structural growth. Now, there's kind of rare, hard to find skill sets, but the demand is that underpins it is there. I think if you now look, you've cast your mind forwards over the next kind of 12 to 24 months, what we're going to do is try and kind of just grow the business organically. So we're looking to add a significant amount of new heads to the business. We've got to work very hard to retain them and give them the skill sets that they need to really turn into high performing recruiters. And then there's a fantastic opportunity within our business to cross-sell. Of course, when you've come from a background of buy and build, there are a number of clients that might see one of our services, perhaps two. We, in fact, have seven service lines that we can talk to clients about. And there's a real opportunity to improve not only our internal gearing, but also the services that we can give our clients. I think also, and importantly for us moving forward, if we were to see some form of acquisition opportunity, just small, nothing too great, but particularly in America, I think we'd be really interested in that.
So if an opportunity did come up in America or elsewhere, how would you fund it?
I think we'd look to make a small acquisition. I think it would be something for cash, something that would be, it would be important to give us just a foothold in the US market. I think we'd like to try and avoid the startup costs particularly. And if we had something that has a trading license, perhaps a contract background as opposed to a permanent business. But with these things, they come down to culture. If we find the right people and they're working in areas that are going to be interesting to us, I think then we'd probably look quite seriously at it. We have a business in Manchester, for example, that's working in the Manhattan market. We have no right to play there at all. The simple fact is, through their expertise, they can identify candidates with the skills and experience in Manhattan. Now, of course, we could do so much better if we were over there.
So it's an exciting time for the company. You're talking about this, though, as a possible, as a perhaps. Mm. Looking at the next few months ahead, what is on the table? What are your plans? What should investors be looking out for?
Well, I think there are three things that the strategy boils down to in the coming months. One is recruitment of our own staff. We need to significantly add to our fee-earning heads. The business has always been kind of trading recently over the last 18 months at about 300 odd. I'd like to see us add another 40 to 50 fee earners into the business. The other thing about that, of course, is retention. Recruitment has a terrible reputation for retention, and I think we are kind of just slightly above the market average for retention. And we really need to make a big inroads into fixing this. I'd like us to kind of work very hard at the learning and development piece to ensure that everybody that comes to work with us have the necessary skills and are managed by experienced hands who really understand their marketplace to make sure we get the best out of them. A critical part of that is return on investment and how we can speed that up. If we're going to bring 40 or 50 people in, we can't be waiting for 9 months for them to become successful. So we're having to work quite hard now at the skills and the techniques that we're going to put into these people to dramatically reduce that. As I've already mentioned, another part of this is this cross-selling opportunity. We have 1,300 clients currently, and we have nowhere near enough of those clients with any more than three services in. I'd like to see us double the amount of clients that we've got multiple service lines in over the next 12 months. And that would take us from something like 100 to 200 clients, but that would hopefully unleash a great deal of potential.
Well, you're ambitious. You've set yourself some big goals there. I look forward to hearing an update on where you are in the next few months. But it's been great hearing about the company and
your
plans. Thank you.
Thank you.